Dr. Jen Ashton is here with answers for you. First question, does wearing a mask help reduce seasonal allergy symptoms?
Well, we don't have long-term data on this, but it is absolutely plausible that it could, and not just a mask, but regular sunglasses or even those eye shields. I know we all want to get rid of them in the sense of COVID, but this is just kind of common sense when it is allergy season. There is so much pollen in the air. You can see it on the cars, on the windshields, that anything you can do to block that from getting into your upper airway is going to help.
You know what I did this morning in my
what?
Uber, because the windows are down, sneezed in my mask. That is not fine.
Oh, no. No.
No. No. I mean, don't act like that hasn't happened to any of you. It's disgusting.
Where's the mask now?
In the trash.
Okay, all right. Dr. Ashton, question two here. Should I stop taking my anti-inflammatory vitamins supplements before I get the vaccine?
Okay, let's unpack the question in a little more detail. Anti-inflammatories in general, like ibuprofen, there's no official recommendations on this, but most practicing physicians are saying, you know what, don't take that right before the vaccine, the day of, because there's the potential that it could mute your immune response to that vaccine. And then, you know, if you get a fever or any pain afterwards, that's a different story, but you don't want to take it prophylactically. In terms of anti-inflammatory supplements, there's no evidence-based data that supports that they actually even work. So maybe if you're going to get the vaccine, take a break for them also for that reason, but yeah, no.
All right, next question, non-COVID related. Which foods are the worst for high blood pressure?
This is an important question. American Heart Association recommends people cap their daily sodium intake at 1,500 milligrams a day. Now, if you read those labels, those NPs, nutritional profiles, you will be shocked about how much hidden sodium is in everything from bread to condiments. You know, obviously canned soups, deli meats are loaded with them. People with congestive heart failure, much more sensitive to sodium overload. People with kidney disease obviously have to watch out. The flip side, which doesn't get a lot of attention, that I just want to put on your radar, foods that are high in potassium, like bananas or avocados, can lower your blood pressure anywhere from 3 to 5 points. So just don't only focus on avoiding the salt. Look for getting more potassium as well.
All right.
Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.